Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will show you how you can insert an image into the Photoshop and how you can set up a canvas for your design and then save it as a Photoshop document. There are a couple of ways to insert an image into the Photoshop. You can do it by going to File, Open, and then you can choose. You can locate your image and then click open to open it into the Photoshop, and let's close it. There's an easier way to do it. You can just drag it and drop it into this area and it will be opened into the Photoshop. This is an easy and quicker way, and when one image is inserted into the Photoshop, you can again choose another image and try to insert it into the Photoshop. When you see there is a plus sign, and that moment you can drop it to insert the second or some other images if you want to. But you can drag it and drop it into the middle like the first image you inserted, because if you do that, let me show you. Like this, if you drop it here, then it will not open as an individual image, rather it will be a smart object. If you enter it, you can see, let's create a regular layer. You can see a different symbol here, and that makes it a smart object. It's not like a regular layer, so it has some smart features as well. And like if you make it smaller or increase its size, then the quality of the image will remain intact. That means you can increase it or decrease it without affecting its quality, and that's not the property of any regular layer in Photoshop. So there are a lot of other features for smart objects, and let's close this file. Now let's see how you can set up a canvas for your design and then save it as a Photoshop document. Go to File, New, and then you can type the name for a file. I will call it Photoshop example, and the preset, you can choose any of the preset size, like layer or photo or international paper A4 size. You can select any of the preset that will set your width and height, but if you have a specific dimension, then you will put that value like this, 1000, and let's put it 600 like this. You can set it like that and change the unit whatever you like, the pixel, inches, centimeters, millimeters. And if you don't have a specific dimension, then you can just choose any of the preset option, this letter or A4 size, anything, and go to the other options. The resolution is 300. So far I know if you put anything less than the 300, then that will affect the quality of the image. So for your design or any other purpose, you will always choose it for the resolution at least 300. That's a pretty good resolution, and the unit is the pixel per inch, that is PPI. Pixels are the lowest unit of an image, and the color mode. Right now you can see this color mode is set as RGB, that is red, green, blue, three color combination. RGB is suitable for any kind of computer graphics or web graphics. If you want to design for printing purposes, then you need to click the CMYK color, because that's the color mode used for printing purposes. The grayscale is different gray colors shade, and bitmap and lap colors are not used that much. And you will set it to 8-bit, what is set right now. It determines the maximum number of colors that you can use into this document, and the background contents will be white. You can choose whatever you want, but you can change it later. So in the advanced section, you don't need to change anything right now. You can just whenever everything is set, you can just click OK to get your desired canvas, and then you can start doing your design. And also you can insert your image like this, drag and drop to the canvas. As I said already, it's now opened as a smart object. We can increase the size of this image, just set it like this. You don't have to worry about how I'm doing this right now, just focus on what the tutorial is about. If we set some other design here like this, and another design, I'm just doing something to show you how you can create your design. And as you can see that I don't need the entire canvas right now. Here is an empty space, so I can crop it to get rid of it like this. If I press enter, then that is gone. And let's say this is our design, or this is what we wanted, and now we want to save it. So go to File, Save As. You can also do it by keyboard, Control Shift S. That's your command, and it's always a better idea to save it as a PSD document, because it keeps your all the changes in different layers and other options all intact in the PSD file. Make sure you check this layer option, and then you can save it as a PSD file. And after saving it as a PSD file, then you can create your desired file format, like whether it's JPEG or PNG or any other formats. There are some other formats that can keep the layers, like TIFF and maybe some other formats. So that's how you can save your file. And if you want to save it as a JPEG or PNG, any other format, then you can just select it and then click Save. And now you can see a box with some options. It's showing the quality of the image. You can select it as maximum, or you can select it high, medium, any quality you want. You can increase it all the way to 12. Quality 12 is the maximum quality, and I always choose the high 8. I think that's pretty good, and you can choose that one as well. When everything is set, you click OK and your file is saved. Let's check it. Here is the image that we created. And when everything is done, you can click this cross mark to close it. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you guys in the next lessons.